let's construct a truth table for any symbolic statements. So for instance, in this example here, we want to construct a truth table for this statement. Not and then parentheses P and Q. We have a column for P and then Q. So to do this, all you need to do is just assign values for P. So we have true, true, false, false. Because for instance, if P is true, then we pair it to Q to be true and Q to be false. So therefore we have true, 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 false. And then if P is false, Q is could either be true or false. So these are all the possibilities. So you just have to write down all the possibilities for P and Q. For conjunction, this would only be true if both statements are true. So therefore, this is true and the rest are false. To construct the truth table for this, this is just a negation of this statement here. Now, to construct the truth table, all you need to do is construct one more column for the statement not and then quantity P and Q. From T, if you negate true, it becomes false. And then false, it's true, false, and then becomes true, and then false becomes true. If we assign P to be the statement Harvard is a college, and Q to be the statement Yale is a college. Yes, we know they're both true. Harvard is a college and Yale is a college. This symbolic statement here can be written in words as, it is not true that Harvard and Yale are colleges. What is the validity of this statement? We know this to be false. Both P and Q are true. Now, but this statement here is false. That is also consistent to what we got from the truth table. A compound statement that is always true is called a tautology. If you have a compound statement and you construct a truth table for that and truth value for the final column is always true, that means the compound statement is always true no matter what the conditions here are. That statement is called a tautology. In this example here, by looking at this compound table, is this an example of a tautology? No, because we have one instance wherein the statement is false. So therefore, it is not a tautology. Let's construct a truth table for not P or Q and not Q. So to do that, you would always have to start with this column here. Normally, you would start with P and Q, and then you just have to write down all the possibilities. So just write T, T, F, F, and then I'll have T, F, T, F. This would be your first entries. Once you have this one, since we are looking for not P or Q, what you would do is construct a column for not P. So for not P, all you need to do is negate your P. From T, the T becomes F, T, F, F, T, and then this F here is now T. This is now the entries for not P. Then next, you want to find the entries or the truth value for not P or Q. So you're going to look at this column here and this column. Now, OR is a disjunction. So for disjunction, OR means it is true if either of the statements or both statements are true. So look at this one. If either one of the statements is true, then it is true. So here we have true, false. Therefore, it's true. False, false. Both statements are false. Therefore, it's false. Now, both statements are true, therefore it's true. We have false true, so this is true because one of the statements is true. Again, if it's or an or statement, it's true if one of these statements here or both of the statements are true. Next, you construct a column for not Q. To construct a column for not Q, the truth values will just be the negation of the column here. So true is false, negation of true is false, false is true, and then true, false, false, true. Then lastly, to get the truth value for the statement here, we are going to connect this column, we're going to compare this column and this column here, and connect it with this connective AND. For the AND connective, we have to remember that this is only true if both statements are true. Otherwise, the statement is false. On the last row here, both statements here are true, so therefore it is true. The rest are false. The rest are false because not both statements here are true. We have true, false, false. False, true, false. True, false, false. So everything is false, except for this case wherein both statements are true. Now, in some cases, we might be involved with three different statements. So if you have three different statements, then the true-false combinations for compound statements of these three simple statements would be 8. How many different combinations are you looking at when you are going to construct some truth table? If you only have two statements, if you only have P or Q, you have two different truth values for P. You could either have true or false for P, and then for Q, you also have true or false. So you have two outcomes for Q, which is true or false, and for P, you have true or false. So therefore, we have 2 times 2, which is 4 different true-false combinations. If it is already three simple statements, you have 2 times 2 times 2. And 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. So therefore, we have 8 true-false combinations. This is how it would look like. You have 8 rows, right? The first 4 rows would be true. The rest would be false. The next, among these 4 true here, half of these are true, and then half are false. And then the same thing here also. On this group here, these 2 here would be paired to true, and then these 2 would be paired to false. Then lastly, for the third column, you have to group these 2 here, pair it true false. And then these 2 here, you have true false. These 2 here, true false. And these 2 here, true false. So these are all the 8 different true false combinations. Now let's extend our discussion for constructing a table with 8 cases by considering the following statements here. Construct a truth table for the following statement. I study hard and ace the final, or I fail the course. Then suppose you study hard, you do not ace the final, and you fail the course. Under these conditions, is this compound statement true or false? So to do this, we will begin by representing our statements as follows. Let P be the statement I study hard, Q the statement I ace the final, and R is the statement I fail the course. So the first statement will be represented as P is I study hard, and Q, I ace the final. Now, the comma here is used to represent a parenthesis. That means that we have P and Q, parenthesis, or so we have a disjunction. I fail the course, so that is R, or R. We have this first statement, P and Q, and then parenthesis or R. To construct the truth table, all you need to do is you have these eight cases here, and then you construct P and Q. So for P and Q, you know that if you have a conjunction, this is only true if both statements are true. So both of these statements here are true, so therefore you have true, true, the rest would be false. For the third case, you just have to compare this column here to the column here. You have P and Q or R. Now for this junction, this is only false when both statements are false. And you also have to remember that this is true, an OR statement is true if either one or both statements are true. By comparing these two, both are true, so you have true, one is true, true, false, it's true, true, false, it's true, false, false, false. And then true, false, true, false, false is false, true, false is true, and then false, false is false. To answer the condition for part B, look at this row here. We have the conditions for part B. So therefore, the statement is true.